Are you thinking about holidays already? Of course we are going to Greece. Although I'm a Greek guy, I haven't been on every single Greek island, but these are my favorite Greek islands at the moment. So, without further ado, let's jump into my short, colorful list. We start with Chios at number 9. The 8th largest island of the Cyclades, Chios is a hilly island between Naxos and Santorini, characterized by its Cycladic architecture and deep blue clear waters. In Chios, you can relax at Milobotas beach, wander through the narrow streets of Chios Hora, watch the sunset from the chapel of Agios Nikolaos on top of Chios Hora, or from the Odysseus Elites Amphitheater. Chios has the reputation of an all-out international party island from June until the end of August. Those innocent little white houses become discos, bars, rock clubs, you name it. But for those of you who can do without the party, Chios in the off-season is like any other Greek island. One of the best places you have ever been. At number 8 we find Zakynthos, home of the world-famous shipwreck beach and the endangered careta-careta turtles. Zakynthos, or Zante, is among the most popular and most beautiful islands in Greece. The shipwreck beach, only accessible by boat, has magical turquoise waters and white sand, surrounded by dramatic towering cliffs. If you visit in peak season, be prepared for crowds flooding the beach, but the viewpoint is always magical. There are more places with crystal clear water open to visitors, including Korakonissi, Porto Limionas, and my favorite, Plakaki, which requires a very beautiful hike down the cliffs. One of my favorite things to do during our trip to Zakynthos was the boat tour to Marathonissi, Keri Caves and Mizithra Beach. In the afternoon, you can watch the majestic sunset at Keri Lighthouse. Naxos is the largest island of the Cyclades. Its fertile landscape spans mountain villages, ancient ruins, and long stretches of beach. The capital, called Hora, is a port town filled with whitewashed houses, medieval Venetian mansions, and a hilltop castle. Despite being relatively low profile compared to the neighboring islands, Naxos is one of the most enticing destinations in Greece. Its glorious ancient past is responsible for the abundance of ancient sites. The most iconic of them, Portara, is the trademark of Naxos. Apart from its impressive monuments, the island has a beautiful natural landscape and it's the greenest of the Cyclades. In Naxos you can explore mound and cave shafts, and visit enchanting mountain villages like Apiranthos, Philoti, and Halki. You will also see the enormous Kouros statues and the Mutsuna Cable Railway. As for the beaches, those keep swimming at Agiana, Aliko, Agios Prokopis, Mikri Vigla, Ψηλιάμος, and Πλάκα. Before we move on, please take a second to subscribe. I noticed that only 3.6% of the views come from subscribers, so with just one click, you can help the channel a lot. Moving on to number 6, Kefalonia, the biggest of the Ionian islands. Its capital, Argostoli, is built on a hillside overlooking a narrow harbor. Kefalonia has been the filming location of the famous movie Captain Corelli's Mandolin. Beaches with exotic turquoise waters, picturesque villages, mysterious caves, and lush nature make up the magical landscape of Kefalonia. Chances are you've already seen it in pictures and postcards, but trust me, the reality is far better. Worldwide famous for its scenic beaches such as Myrtos, the famous beach backed with towering cliffs, Φτέρι, Sea Beach, Antisamos, Megas Lakos, and Platis Gialos. Dramatic landscapes with enchanting villages like Fiskardo, and Assos, mountain lovers can climb Mount Enos, the highest mountain of the Ionian Islands. The exploration continues in the lake cave of Melissani. In Kefalonia we had an amazing time as we managed to stay in the lighthouse. Corfu is one of the most beautiful and romantic islands of the Ionian Sea. From lush green hills to noble mansions and from idyllic beaches to impressive museums, this island has everything it takes to please any type of traveler. Corfu town, the capital, is a brilliant base for exploration. Get lost in the narrow cobblestone alleys, the so-called Kandunia. Walk down the famous Liston Promenade, stroll around the huge Pianada Square. When you manage to live away from the enchanting Corfu town, move to the coast of Corfu, Paleokastritsa, Porto Timoni, Cape Δράστης, γυαλί are worthy of a visit. As for sightseeing, numerous places of historical and cultural interest are always ready to welcome visitors, like the Achillean Palace, the former retreat of Princess Sissi of Austria, the historic fort, Παναγία Βλαχέρνα, ένα γελόκαστρο. Number 4, Milos. Thanks to its volcanic origin, Milos, sitting in the heart of the Aegean Sea, has a magnificent, colorful landscape and a coastline that has more than 60 exotic beaches, with the most famous being the gorgeous Sarakiniko Beach. Κλεφτικό, with its towering rock formations and emerald waters, not reachable only by boat as most people think. We actually hiked there. Τσιγκράδο,
Τσιγκράδο Beach.
Φυρίπλακα, Παπαφράγκας, the hidden gems of Milos are its colorful fishing villages. In these small villages, like Klima and Phyropotamos, you'll find little whitewashed houses, sirmata, with shutters painted in vivid colors. Many of these have been turned into cozy accommodations by the sea.
In my room right now, without you. And I couldn't really make you stay, so what to do? I'm just staring at my walls and talking to myself. Now and then I'll try to laugh, but I'll cry a bit as well. I was never any good.
And of course, make sure you walk around in the beautiful villages of Plaka and Tripiti. Moving on to the top 3, we find Santorini. To all Santorini lovers out there, I'm sorry if you thought it was going to be number 1. I really love Santorini. I visited about 15 times, but it's gonna make it to number 3 for this list. Santorini is one of the most popular travel destinations worldwide. The caldera and the enormous cliffs, filled with whitewashed houses, offer the most dramatic sea views you have ever seen. The landscape of Santorini, with the famous caldera, the volcanic beaches and of course the volcano's crater in Nea Kameni is one of a kind. Accommodation is special too, with all the infinity pools and luxury villas. Never thought of Santorini as an island with great beaches, but there are some beautiful ones, like the Red Beach, White Beach, Black Beach for that matter. Apart from the caldera section with Fira, Imerovigli, Firo Stefani, Endia, make sure you visit the very beautiful villages of Pyrgos, Εμποριό, Μεγαλοχώρη. Also, it would be a great idea if you have time to visit Tirasia and get amazing views of Santorini. Without doubt, the ultimate highlight is the enchanting sunset, but not only from Fira Oria. There are also other, less crowded spots. High mountains, pristine landscapes, fragrant pine groves, traditional villages, turquoise waters and rich history make Karpathos the runner-up of this list. Its natural landscape remains unspoiled and its beaches are magnificent. Only its southern side is developed and the rest of the island maintains its authentic atmosphere. Karpathos stands out for its stunning beaches, Kira Panagia, Αχάτα, Άπελα, Διακόφτης, Finiki are some of the most beautiful and popular beaches in Karpathos. The island is filled with little villages that ooze a traditional charm. The most beautiful is Olympos, filled with windmills and churches, while women wear traditional costumes in their everyday life. But you should also visit the villages of Menetes, Arkasa, Όθος, εν Μεσοχώρη. You say that I'm just wasting my time. Mykonos fans, sorry but not sorry. Number one in my list is Crete. Does the fact that I have lived here for the last 11 years play a role? Of course. Is it due to the fact that it is the biggest Greek island? In this case, size does matter. But its beauty is even bigger than its size, where natural beauty meets rich culture and worldwide famous gastronomy. On this big island, I'm still exploring the hundreds of beaches, hundreds of gorges, the more than 55 peaks over 2,000 meters, and hundreds of beautiful villages. On Crete, you will find some of the most famous beaches in the world, like Balos, Vai,
love the way we are together. Can we always stay this way? And how I wanna
Kefalonia. But there are many hidden gems waiting to be explored. My next video will be about the best beaches of Crete, so make sure you subscribe not to miss it. Crete is one of the most popular Greek destinations, thanks to its unreal beaches, its amazing historical sites, and its mesmerizing natural landscapes. If you are a thrill seeker, there's a whole heap of things to do in the nature of Crete. Dramatic gorges, imposing mountains, and trekking routes will fulfill your hiking needs. In the description below, you can find the link to my favorite hikes in Crete. And what can we say about the food? The local gastronomy is popular not only in Greece, but also in the whole world. And yes, in the description below, there is a link for that too. My favorite places to eat around Chania. What do you think? Is it time to put Crete in your bucket list? Let us know in the comments below, which is your favorite Greek island? If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and subscribe for more videos from Greece and abroad. Thank you for watching, see you next time.